n8n just added native support for Model Context Protocol, and it is awesome. You would have seen tons of videos covering MCP on n8n already, but these videos all used a community component and not the official integration offered by n8n. And I made it clear that I was not going to cover the community node, as quite honestly, it was very difficult to set up and extremely hardware intensive. In fact, my self-hosted instance of n8n kept crashing due to the insane requirements from this community node. So I'm not trying to bash the developer of that node, but unfortunately, I couldn't get it working reliably. But thankfully, we now have native support within n8n. And the good news is we can now build MCP servers directly within n8n as well. And of course, we can use n8n as an MCP client as well. And in this video, I will show you both approaches. And I'll also discuss certain limitations with the native integration as it currently stands. Now for me, the most exciting feature is the ability to create MCP servers. As an example, I've got this very simple MCP server setup that connects to an existing workflow. It can send emails and read emails, and it can also manage my to-do list items for me. Now, once you've set up an MCP server, you can integrate it into several AI-based applications that support MCP, like Claude Desktop or code editors like Cursor. You will now notice in Claude Desktop that we can see 6 available tools. These are the tools that I attach to my MCP server in n8n, like add to do, create content, create email, list to do's, read emails, and update to do's, each of the tools listed within this workflow. This now means that Claude has access to any of those tools. So what I can do is say, what are my current to do's? And Claude will now realize we've got access to these tools, and is simply asking my permission to run this list to do's from n8n. So let's approve this, and now it's listing all of my to-dos. Now these to-dos are coming from this tool over here, which is linked to an Airtable table. So buy bread is set to complete, and we've got call mom and buy dog food, which are not yet complete. So let's update our to-dos. Let's say add another to-do called wash the car, and also set the call mom to-do to complete. Let's send this. Right, so the agent's calling our add to do tool, which we can approve. And now it's trying to update the existing to do. So let's approve this. And now Claude is saying done. And if we switch over to our table and give it a refresh, we can see call mom was indeed completed and wash car was added to the to do. Now in our workflow, we also have access to email. So what we can do in Claude then is say email the list of to do's to test@test.com. All right, so first it's grabbed the list of to-dos. Now it's asking us if it's allowed to send the email. Let's do that. And it's saying it created an email draft and switching over to the email and going to my email draft folder. I can see this draft over here, which contains my list of to-dos. Of course, I could also just add a send email tool and the tool will instantly be made available to all these MCP clients. And for completeness sake, we can see the exact same tools in Cursor. So in Cursor, we see update to-dos, add to-dos, list to-dos, create email, read emails, and create content. So let's say something like, write a story about my dog called Ruby riding a magical cloud and create a draft email with the final story. Let's send this. So now it's calling our create content tool. So let's run this. And while this is running, I just want to point out that the content creator tool is this one over here, which is actually a separate workflow within n8n. Okay, so it's created the story. And of course, you can expand any of these to see exactly what happened. So we can see the query that was sent to n8n. And in the output, we can see the result coming back from n8n. And if I show you what that workflow looks like, this is calling an AI agent, which is then generating the story for us and returning it. So the point is, you can attach agentic workflows as a tool as well. So now that we have our story, it's asking us to create the email. So let's go ahead and approve this. All right, so it's saying it generated the story and the email and refreshing my drafts. And there we go, we've received the email containing that story. This is insane. Now let's have a look at setting up the server and integrating it into Claude Desktop or Cursor, and afterwards I'll show you how to use n8n as an MCP client. To create an MCP server, simply create a new workflow, and I'll just call this MCP Server YouTube Demo. Then for the first step, search for MCP and add the MCP Server trigger. All right, looking at this node, it gives us a test URL and a production URL. We can also set authentication, so we can set a bearer token or header auth. I'll simply have no authentication, and yes, I will be removing this endpoint by the time you watch this video. Let's rename the path to tutorial. We will come back to this URL in a minute. Now we can add any tools to this MCP trigger, and these tools will become available to any application that's using our MCP server. So this could be extremely simple. We could attach something like a calculator tool. And before we add anything else, let's save this and let's have a look at adding this super simple server to Cursor and Claude Desktop. To download Claude Desktop, go to claude.ai/download and download and install Claude for your operating system. Then from Claude, go to the top menu, then go to File, Settings, click on Developer, and at this point you won't see any MCP servers. Click on Edit Config, and this should take you to the folder containing this Claude Desktop Config file. Now open up this file in a text editor or a code editor. I'll simply use Claude, but of course use any text editor you want. Now in this file, add the following. You can copy all of this from the description in this video. Simply replace this URL with the URL from your server trigger config. So in this trigger, click on production URL, copy whatever value is in this field, and add it to this file. Then save this file. And finally, also ensure to activate this workflow. Cool, so it's active. And now the next time you start up Claude, you will now see this tool icon showing the available tools from your MCP server, which for now is only the calculator tool. You no longer have to change anything in the config file. When you add new tools to your n8n workflow, they will automatically reflect in this list. Now, I also want to show you how to integrate this with Cursor, which is another super popular use case, and this is probably something I see using all the time. Download and install Cursor, and when you access Cursor, you can go to File, Preferences, Cursor Settings, and from here go to MCP, then click on Add New Global MCP Server, and paste in that same text. And if we go back to our Cursor Settings, we can see that n8n is now connected, as well as the list of available tools, which is only the calculator for now. If this is showing yellow or red for you, simply click on Refresh, and that should resolve the issue. Now you can follow along using Cursor or Claude, it's really up to you. I'll personally be using Cursor for the remainder of this tutorial. So in the example I showed at the start of this video, we had this content generator workflow, and we will be creating this, and we also had the ability to manage our to-dos. Something like sending email is very common, so I'm not going to explain that in this video, but what we'll do is create our content generator workflow, just so that I can show you how to call sub workflows, and then we'll also learn how to manage our to-dos. To call sub workflows, what we can do is go back to our dashboard, let's create a new workflow, and let's call this one something like social media post generator. All right, so then let's click on add first step, and here let's add when executed by another workflow. For the input data mode, let's leave it on define using fields below. Let's add a new field, and I'm going to call this one query, and it's of type string. Let's also set some mock data just so that we can test this. I'm going to remove all of these, and using opening and curly braces, let's add this query property with a value of create a Twitter or X post on using AI agents with n8n. Now let's save this, and let's go back to the canvas. Now this workflow will call an AI agent to generate this content for us. Now of course, this doesn't have to be an agent, you could just call a basic LLM chain, but because I'm a little bit lazy, I'll simply attach the agent node. Let's change the source to define below, and let's simply add our query to the prompt. We can also add a system message where we can say something like, you are a helpful assistant who creates professional social media content. Cool. Let's go back to the canvas. Let's add our chat model. And what's beautiful about this is if you are running n8n locally, you could use an open source model using OLAMA. I'll simply attach OpenAI. I'll leave this on GPT-4o mini. And that should be it. Let's test this workflow. And if we look at the agent's output, we can see our Twitter post over here. Awesome. Now let's save this. Then let's go back to our MCP server. Let's click on tools. Let's select call n8n workflow tool. And now we can give it a name like create underscore social underscore media underscore content. And for the description, let's say use this tool when creating social media posts. Right now, all we have to do is select our workflow, which we called social media post generator. And because we're using the AI agent node, we can simply let the AI figure out what the query should be. Let's go back to the canvas. I'm just going to rename this node to social post generator, like so. Now watch what happens when we save this flow. We can simply restart Claude Desktop, or if you're using Cursor, simply refresh this list and you will now see this new tool. If I press Ctrl I in Cursor, this will bring up this chat window. And now we can test this out. Let's just say, create an X post about AI agents taking our jobs. So Cursor saw that we've got this tool available. Let's approve it. And if we look at the output of this tool, you can indeed see the output from our agent. So this makes this extremely powerful. We now have our social media post generator and a calculator tool. Something I actually use is a to-do list. So what we can do is go to Airtable and create a table with two columns, a name column and completed. Here I've added a few items and I've set two of them to complete. So what I can do in the server is to add a new tool. Let's add Airtable, like so. And I'm just going to rename this to list to-dos. And for the operation, let's change this to search. And for the base, let's select to-dos. And for the tables, let's select to-dos as well. I'm going to refilter out and I am going to return all items. And for the options, let's select output fields. And from here, let's select name as well as completed. I created plenty of videos where I show you how to integrate Airtable with n8n. So if you are a bit lost, I'll simply link to other videos in the description of this video. Let's go back to the canvas and let's add two more Airtable nodes. So let's search for Airtable. Select Airtable tool. For the operation, let's select create. Let's select our base. Let's select the table. And for mapping, we'll leave it on map each column manually. And for the name, we'll let the AI decide. And initially completed will be set to false. This is a new to-do after all. Let's also rename this node to add to-do. Cool. And let's add the last one. Let's call this one Airtable. Let's change the operation to update, and let's actually rename this node to update to do. This tool will allow us to set a to do to completed or incomplete. All right, so then for the values to update, let's let the AI decide, and let's also add a description, and let's add something like the Airtable record ID, usually in the format like this. So we can use this description field just to assist the AI in defining how it's supposed to populate this field. And I've run into issues with Airtable IDs in the past. So I'd rather give it some sort of guidance. All right, for the name, I'm also going to let the AI decide. And I'll also let the agent decide how to set completed. And I think that should be it. Let's go back to the canvas. Let's save our server. And back in Cursor, let's refresh this list. And cool, we now have our to-do tools. Let's give this a spin. Let's say, what are my current to-dos? Let's run this tool. And how cool is that? We now get our to-dos back. Let's try adding a to-do, like add a new to-do called create n8n MCP tutorial. All right, let's approve this tool call. And let's approve this one as well. So it's just trying to retrieve the tools to see whether it was added or not. And looking at Airtable, we can indeed see our to-do over here. We can also use these servers as tools in our other agent flows. Here, I've got a super simple agent setup. It can receive chat messages. We have the AI agent node, and there's nothing fancy in here at all. And we're simply using OpenAI as our LLM. Now to add an MCP server as a tool, all we have to do is click on tool, then let's select MCP client tool. And all we have to do now is provide that endpoint to our server. So let's click on our server. Let's grab this endpoint. And in the MCP client tool, let's add in our endpoint. If we enable authentication on the server, this is where we would have to set that authentication. And here we can tell it which tools to include. By default, we can just pull in all the tools, which is effectively what Claude and Cursor is doing. But if we wanted to, we could be very specific. So in this list, we can see all the available tools from the server. I'm simply going to leave it as all and let the agent decide when to call which tool. Right, so let's save this. Let's give this a spin and let's say list my to-dos. And awesome, here we can see all my to-dos. And now let's say mark the create n8n MCP tutorial as done. All right, the agent is saying it was marked as done and going to Airtable. We can see that this update did indeed happen. Now I'm going to show you a very funny tip. But before I do that, I do want to mention one limitation with the current implementation. For MCP clients, we're only able to call SSE endpoints. Now, if you are familiar with Model Context Protocol, you know that there are plenty of other servers available as well. And if I look at Brave Search, as an example, some of these servers require you to run npx commands, which is very different to SSE. And unfortunately, we can't currently use any of these servers natively in n8n. However, there's one very funny trick that you can do. Zapier also offers an SSE endpoint, which gives you access to a lot of different integrations. And I know Zapier is effectively n8n's competition, but if there is an integration within Zapier that you'd like to use in n8n, all you have to do is go to zapier.com/mcp, then click on Get Started, and here you'll find an SSE endpoint to Zapier. So all you have to do is copy this URL and then add it to n8n. So simply remove this and paste in that Zapier URL. Now you can decide which actions you want to add to your server by clicking on Edit MCP Actions. And at the moment, I've got Gmail set up, but you can click on Add New Action, and now you can search through the thousands of integrations offered by Zapier. For instance, let's look for Discord, and now you can find all these different actions related to Discord. Like, let's just say, send channel message. And of course, Zapier will take you through the setup instructions to connect to Discord. Either way, if you go to n8n, and if we click on Selected, we can see all the actions that's now being pulled in from Zapier itself. So I just thought this is a very cool tip to add even more functionality to n8n. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel for more n8n content, and also check out my full tutorial on building AI agents in n8n. I'll see you in the next video.